Hey there, everyone. Welcome to this week's Astrology Report. This is for October 31 through November 6 of 2023. I hope you're all doing well. In this report, I'm going to start off listing all the major aspects for the week ahead, and there is quite a few here. And then I'm going to briefly summarize the week and what we might experience before I go through the chart day by day, talk about all these aspects throughout the week. So let's take a quick look here at the aspects, and the main ones are going to be Venus trine Uranus. That's already come exact today. We also have Mercury in conjunct to Chiron. We have the Sun opposing Jupiter. That's going to be one of the biggest ones this week. We have Venus in conjunct to the North Node of Destiny, Venus opposing Neptune. We have Saturn stationing direct. That's the other major event this week. That's going to be by November 4 when it's perfect, but it's considered all week long here, stationary. And Mercury is opposing Uranus. We have the last quarter moon phase of this current eclipse cycle, crisis and consciousness phase, coming by November 5. Mars is in conjunct to Chiron. Venus begins to trine Pluto by next Monday as Mercury is in conjunct to the North Node of Destiny, and Mercury trines Neptune. So there is quite a bit there. However, the moon is waning, coming off of that full moon eclipse. And the moon isn't going to make any aspects, the moon isn't going to make any conjunctions this week to planets. It will make aspects to all these other planets, but no conjunctions until next week when the moon finally reaches Venus. So the moon will be waning through the sign of Gemini, all through the sign of Cancer, all through Leo, where it becomes the last quarter moon phase, and then in Virgo by next week. Overall, everything is still reporting to Mars. Mars is the strongest planet in the sky right now. Mars is the main dispositor, so Mars is in charge of everything going on. You know, so for example, the moon is in Gemini right now. The moon in Gemini would typically rather be light and playful and more intellectual and communicative in a more playful spirit. But the moon in Gemini is ruled by Mercury, and Mercury is in Scorpio conjunct Mars, which it's under the rulership of Mars. Violence, intensity, aggression, these undercurrents of power and control, and everything Scorpio, the dark side of life. So unfortunately, that's going to be the dominant theme throughout this week is Scorpio. That's where the sun is shining its light. That's where the mind is, the communications are. And it's all wrapped around Mars, aggression, violence, intensity, passion, complex emotions that are under the surface, the dark side of life, basically. And this is a major opposition that we've been dealing with already all of October, is this Scorpio versus Taurus opposition, light versus dark. And Jupiter here is being lit up this week by the sun. It's at its brightest point as the sun is exactly opposite Jupiter. So it's very bright up in the sky. You might have seen it on the full moon as well, you know, when it was right next to the moon. So there's still this big boost of the light in Taurus, the physical side of life, material side, the earthly side of five senses of pleasure, money and resources, and trying to keep things stable and calm and beautiful despite all these intense undercurrents and what's going on in the general mundane context of the world and within certain people's lives, of this deeper dynamic that the spotlight is on right now with Mars. And with this battle between Scorpio and Taurus that we've been dealing with, you know, Mars wins because it's the most powerful. Venus, which rules Taurus, is still in its debilitation. It's not as strong. And now Venus is coming into some complex alignments this week with Neptune and Uranus and Pluto, which just makes it a little more challenging as well. So it's also this opposition between money and resource dynamics, things that we want right now versus investments, things that are developing for the future. And I think the future is where we get the best stuff. You have to be very patient with what you want right now in life, because this Taurus isn't quite ready yet to give us everything we want. With Jupiter, Uranus retrograde, ruled by debilitated Venus, entering some foggy territory this week with Neptune, plus Saturn stationing direct. Saturn is about patience. Everything that Saturn rules is going to be extra powerful, extra strong this week because of its stationary. From the Earth's perspective, Saturn not moving makes, you know, it very powerful and closer to the Earth. And basically it says that we've been internalizing Saturn situations for the last several months. Responsibilities, commitments, duties, obligations, things that we need to build, structure, and move forward in the future, especially in a context of Pisces. So now this momentum is shifting into a more externalized way of commitments, responsibilities, plus Saturn is patience. You have to be very patient with everything going on right now. It will lead to abundance if you have the responsibility and the commitment to build, work hard, and structure things in an outer way in your life now for the next several months. However, Saturn is still deep in its retrograde shadow, and it's going to take, you know, it won't come out of its shadow into new territory until 2024. You know, late winter, spring 2024, it starts moving forward in even newer ways. But from now until then, we're still dealing with things that we've had to deal with for most of 2023. So wherever you have Pisces, that's where there's this outer level, this externalizing of commitments, responsibility, work, duty, patience, boundaries become stronger. Karma becomes stronger. What you've created for the last 5 to 6 months, now you're going to see the result of, you know, because you've had a little bit of this opportunity not to be able to, not being forced to take responsibility in a certain way. And now as Saturn shifts its power outward, we're forced to take responsibility. We're forced to work in new ways and build and structure and commit. And so Pisces is really going to feel this wherever you have Pisces in your birth chart. And then, you know, all the mutable signs are going to feel this, because if you have planets between the first 0 to 7 degrees of the mutable signs, you're under a rare Saturn transit this year. And now it's going to, you're going to feel that final push to deal with those situations that are a little bit more tough, restrictive, limiting that you've had to deal with this year. So that includes any planets in Pisces, first 7 degrees, Gemini, Virgo, and Sagittarius. All the mutable signs are going through a tough Saturn transit this year. And so those things become a little more heavier, a little more serious as we start moving forward this week. So overall, with Saturn, the planet of seriousness, so powerful, and Mars, so powerful, and Scorpio of intensity, we continue to feel serious and intense for the most part while trying to escape into something more pleasurable, feel the love, feel the pleasure of life and stability and the beauty. And we're still wanting these better sides of life so much despite the seriousness and intensity under the surface that continues to be a theme throughout this week. So that's the general summary, and the mind is also really being stimulated this week with a lot of Mercury aspects. So with that said, let's go through the chart day by day here and see what's going on here. We start with Tuesday, October 31st, and the first aspect was Venus perfecting a trine with Uranus. That was really early in the morning. And so now Venus is separating from that, but it's still within orb here of Uranus, which shows this opening, this ability to find pleasure in alternative ways, but it's still very physical and practical ways. But there's still an opening for something different, to be attracted to something different, to find value in things that are different. And that's going to last for the next day or two, perhaps, and then it'll get weaker as Venus starts moving forward and is applying to the opposition to Neptune. But for the rest of today, the moon has been in conjunct to Mars. The moon has been in conjunct to Mercury. So this is where the moon in Gemini, which is stimulating the need for communications and networking and multitasking, being more busy and intellectual. And typically, you know, it's about being more lighthearted and playful and youthful and agile. But it comes back to this Mercury in Scorpio, which is right next to Mars. So normally where Gemini is stimulating mental activity and communications in a more lighthearted way, it's not going to be as lighthearted in this phase because of the Scorpio connection to it. And the moon is in conjunct to that Scorpio because they don't mix very well. Gemini and Scorpio are nothing alike. So there's a lot of this agitation between where the mood is, the moon, circumstances and the feelings and the overall mood of the day wants to be more lighthearted and playful and communicative, but there's these more secretive, under the surface vibes, the unspoken things that we're having to adjust to, and the overall emotional intensity that the moon in Gemini would rather not deal with. So the mind is intense. It's a lot harder to be more outward with our communication in an intellectual way, like the air signs. And so with the moon here, it is allowing us to do that. It is allowing more outward communication and networking, like I said, and just general social vibes. But it still comes back to this edginess with Mercury and Mars in the eighth house. So the moon is having to make these adjustments today to these very different vibes. But the moon in Gemini, that can be short trips, traveling, siblings coming into focus, generally speaking here. Neighbors and just general busyness and multitasking and just doing a variety of different things and being interested in a variety of different things today as well. But it could also stir up the need for research, investigation, digging deep for things, you know, that we're mentally stimulated with the moon in these positions. And then the last aspect of the day for Tuesday is the moon sextile Chiron. So moon in Gemini connecting to Chiron in Aries gives opportunity to feel a little better about the self as well. Could be some healing activity, but overall, you know, these Mars and this Scorpio transit is also in conjunct to Chiron, and there's a lot of death in the world right now. There's a lot of violence and wounds and trauma, you know, so that's still going to be a major theme, you know, all this week. But the moon is connecting to that in some way, so it's not that, it's just a sextile, but, and it's only temporary, but it can be helpful for the mood or the feelings for people as the day goes on in the evening here. And that's all we have for today. Until we get to November 1st, 2023 here. And the moon is at the last degrees of Gemini. And the first aspect of the day is the moon square Venus. And then the moon, yeah, it's a lot of moon, Venus, and Neptune vibes here, because the moon is starting to form a T-square with Venus and Neptune, which is going to kind of activate the beginning of this opposition between Venus and Neptune. So the moon, as we come into Wednesday, is still in this position of wanting to be lighthearted, communicative, busy, networking, mentally stimulated. It still comes back to these deeper situations of Scorpio, a little more edgy. But first thing on Wednesday morning, moon square Venus for the first aspect of the day. And that is where emotionally people want Venus. People want the good stuff. People want to connect to relationship or love or money or pleasures, and there's a little bit of a challenge in that. Sometimes moon square Venus can be a sense of not feeling quite satisfied, kind of hard to get the pleasure, even though it's very stimulated and there's still opportunity to feel pleasure or engage in something that's more enjoyable, but there's tension in that process. And the thing is this square between moon and Venus on Wednesday morning, they're both in Mercury sign. So Mercury rules what's going on here, and Mercury's in Scorpio, making an in conjunction to Chiron. So unfortunately, this can show some issues of some wounds still, some deeper intensity still, money and resource stuff that's still a little bit not the best right now for people, not feeling quite satisfied or loved, or hurt feelings are very easily coming up for people. And then there can be emotional confusion as the moon squares Neptune first thing in the morning. You know, uncertainty, confusions, doubts, you know, questioning yourself, not quite sure what's going on here, or the need to completely escape the intensity, the tougher feelings that are in the background, avoidance. So moving into your own world, behind the scenes, art, beauty, movies, you know, creativity really stimulated. It's just not in a very easy flowing way to achieve that in a good way or feel content or satisfied necessarily through it. But there could definitely be this need to escape into something more pleasurable and nice and avoid the more serious, heavy stuff. I just don't think that's going to be easy with the ruler of all this in conjunct to Chiron of wounds and heaviness and seriousness, plus the Saturn. You know, it's not just a one-day stationary event. Saturn is not moving from our perspective at all this week. So there's a lot of seriousness and intensity, despite the needs, the feelings, and the mood for something more pleasurable and light. It can also stir up weather events. You know, I always say this, when the moon is squaring Neptune, there's usually major events. In fact, on my last report, remember when I said the moon was reaching Neptune and it was wet and stormy? There was that hurricane that hit Mexico during that Pisces transit with Neptune. So moon and Neptune stirs up water events or storminess, fogginess. You know, it's like there's a lot of intensity because Neptune in Pisces is actually amplifying things. So the mood gets amplified, but it's more in a not the most solid, grounded way. And that's only a temporary aspect, but it does kind of activate, like I said, this Venus opposing Neptune for the rest of the week. And the moon is also in alignment with the nodes of fate, so it could be a fateful day on Wednesday as well. And then as I was saying, Mercury is in conjunct to Chiron. And that's not an easy situation there. And I think the moon is activating that with something around this time, first thing in the morning on Wednesday, having to make adjustments to deeper situations and feelings and wounds and sensitivities and trauma and, you know, of course, death. We can't deny that. There's a lot of death happening in these wars and other situations around the world that don't get the headlines that you don't even know about. You know, there's a lot of darker, deeper things happening in this phase right now. And this will begin to change the mood for Wednesday because the moon is also in conjunct to Pluto, you know, during all of this first thing in the morning, which again is having to make adjustments to powerful situations out in the world, power control issues, things that are outside of our control, things that are a little more heavy and intense versus this mood that wants to keep things light and playful and intellectual and detached. And it's just a bit of a stormy mess in some context on Wednesday, first half of the day at least. And then that leads to a change as the moon will ingress Cancer. And I think this is a change for the better. As the moon comes into its home sign, it's making an aspect to Saturn in a nice way, and it begins to build trines to the Scorpio from this point on. Now, Venus has a wide orb, you know, a grand trine to Pluto and Uranus in the Earth signs, but it's a pretty wide orb. I don't really consider that, even though it looks like there's that grand trine, it's not really exact. First, Venus has to make the opposition to Neptune. Then it can make this stronger application to Pluto, which will be something a little more practical and grounded than the opposition to Neptune. But Venus is still not in a very bad way here. However, the moon is in charge of itself. The moon doesn't report to anything. So whereas Mars is in charge of all these transits, there's a temporary phase here where when the moon is in transit through Cancer, it's in charge of itself in its own situation that's able to feel more secure and safe and comfortable. But in general, the moon coming into Cancer on Wednesday afternoon night will bring a lot of more of home circumstances, a mood for the home, a mood for more of safety, security, and comfort, and family dynamics. It brings up energy about borders and homeland and your inner feelings about things. It's a much more sensitive mood. But in the beginning, it's still a mature kind of vibe here with the moon trine Saturn. So maturity, responsibility, commitments and duties, obligations connected to home, family, property, and your overall internal world become a strong emotional need. and playing it safe, being more conservative and cautious in this phase as well by Wednesday night. And that's the last aspect of the day until Thursday, November 2nd, and the moon is waning through Cancer and begins to trine the sun for Thursday, which is very helpful. The moon is also sextile Jupiter, and the moon is trine Mars. For the first part of the day, this is typically more emotionally safe and secure. The vibes are generally more smooth. But remember when I say these positive things, that there's still the bigger theme is the dark side, the intense side, the serious side of life that's playing out. But it just shows that there is some part of this for the first half of Thursday that feels more cooperative and smooth. Emotionally, we're in harmony with what we're focused on. Money, resources, things for the future, investments connected to home, property, real estate, family stuff, you know, is in good alignment in general. And, you know, but your personal transits may vary. However, it's a pretty good alignment for the first part of the day. And then the second half of the day is when the sun opposes Jupiter, you know, which happens once a year and where Jupiter's at its brightest of the year. But it's still in opposition. However, it's Jupiter. I don't necessarily look at this as a like a major bad aspect, but it does put up some opposition between, you know, everything being a little bit overly amplified and extreme sometimes in some cases. But this is ruled by Venus, and Venus is applying towards this more dreamy, romanticizing, has expectations about something that's more hopeful and dreamy in some context. So there could be like, you know, plus the moon in this harmony, there could be a sense of like, you're starting to see something, you want something, there's a mood for something, and it could be a really big mood for something as the moon sextiles Jupiter. You know, also physical stuff, material stuff of life, money and resources, and developments that could happen in the future connected to the property, the home, and the family developments in some way. So, for example, you might, you know, maybe this Taurus full moon says, I want a new home, I want something better to live in that's more luxurious or just more abundant in some way. Well, Jupiter's retrograde, Venus is debilitated. You might not get that right now, but again, the next 6 months, there's going to be this development in your Taurus area of life that says there is going to be an increase to value and money and resources in some context in your life. And now the moon is picking up that, you know, so this could be where you're looking at homes or you're preparing, you're dreaming about something bigger. That's a fundamental need for your foundation of life, home and family matters, or property, or real estate, you know, something in that context. It could vary depending on your own transits and what it means for you personally, but that's an example. You know, in the general context, property, borders, home, family, connecting to money, resources, investments, and things like that for Thursday, November 2nd. Now, the last aspect of, well, let me continue with the sun opposite Jupiter. This can also bring up a little bit of opposition between belief systems. Coming back to what I said about the eclipse with Jupiter, your belief systems about material, financial things need to change in order to get what you want, you know, that you would really like to have in this bigger way for your future. You have to kind of change your perspective, your beliefs, your opinions that are outdated and need to be updated. As Jupiter is moving retrograde in this position, it's internalizing things that you've already been dealing with this year, helping you see what you don't have versus what you want. And the sun is shining its light on that, you know, of this growth, this potential. But you have to work it out internally before Jupiter stations direct at the end of the year, starts moving these things forward for 2024. And then, like I said, by spring of 2024, you might actually see the results of what you want right now. So, you know, the sun is still forming opposition. You have to be careful of overconfidence in something, doing too much, spending too much money is a potential with this. Or you might have, like, it might be a spotlight on something big. You know, it's not something small necessarily, but the resources may not be there with Venus debilitated in a very small sign of Virgo, ruling all these big needs and big desires for something. So make sure it's in proportion and balanced and not overly done or overly confident or something in that regard when it comes to money and resources and home and family property stuff. But it's still stimulating hope and dreams and wishes and the need for something. But then the moon does square Chiron later on that night, and that's a little bit of a emotionally uncomfortable situation in some context as well. But all day, the moon is, you know, trine Mars, and, you know, it could be a very active day, especially in that context of safety, security, comfort, home and family property, and money and resource matters, taking action, but still playing it safe with the moon in Cancer. You still don't want to step outside of comfort zone with this type of vibe. But there's still something, I would say, on Thursday night that's bringing up some general sensitivity about individuality or the need to start, initiate something, home and family stuff, the self versus home and family relationships and things like that could be stimulated. It's only a temporary aspect, but it could be a little bit uncomfortable or emotional or sensitive in some way. But yet the mind and the moon, the feelings, the mind and the heart, they're still aligned very nicely. But it's emotional, you know, it's watery, it's intuitive. And that's the last aspect until the following day on Friday, November 3. And the moon, you know, separating from the trine to Mercury, the mind and heart still in alignment for first thing on Friday morning. And then the moon is also applying a sextile and a trine to the Venus-Neptune opposition that becomes exact on Friday. So we first have Venus in conjunct to the North Node on Friday morning. So, you know, maybe something that was going on the previous day with money and resource matters for the future, investments, just general values and money stuff, there could be this big dream, this big hope, this fantasy, this wish, you know, with Venus aligning with Neptune. And we'll have to make adjustments to the future based on these things that are playing out. You know, these things playing out midweek to the end of the week could have an effect on your long-term future in some way, potentially. And then we also see that the moon is sextile Uranus, again, connecting to something that's alternative, something that's different within this financial and this home family situation that's being stirred up this week. Being willing to try something new, being comfortable with change and something new on a material value, physical level. And then the moon is T-square, the nodes of fate. So it's a very fateful day. Home and family matters, property, your internal world are at a crossroads between home, family, the self, your individuality, your future, and relationships, family relationships. So it's a very fateful day of anything happening this week, especially the second half of this week. Again, could put your life at a crossroads for the long-term future, for good or bad. And then the moon is sextile Venus, and we're able to feel some sort of contentment with pleasure, with relationship stuff. It's very important stuff most likely happening in general on Friday for people. Thursday and Friday with this home, family, property situation in general, like I said, so not every single person. But for a little bit there on Friday afternoon, there's this ability to connect to relationship, pleasure, money. There's still some limitation to it. To me, it still feels like the future, you know, of what people are really kind of wrapped up into with that Taurus full moon becoming illuminated and, and like I keep saying, this Taurus area that's going to be developed in a big new way that's quite abundant for 2024. But because Venus is still not at its best right now, it just doesn't feel like you're getting everything you want right now, but there could still be a lot of hopes and fantasies and wishes and dreams being stirred up, and overall some contentment in the moment on Friday afternoon. But, you know, there's going to be a big mood shift after that. It's complicated because the moon is going to be activating this Pluto, but at the same time, Venus and the moon are aspecting Neptune. That almost gives this sense of escaping some of the more intense emotions that are stirring up, or the circumstances on Friday evening and Friday night that are stirring up. But that's when Venus becomes exact opposite Neptune, second half of Friday. So this affects relationships. It affects money. Again, I feel like it has that financial connection of a hope and a wish and a dream. But you have to keep expectations in check with Venus opposite Neptune. The value planet, the desire planet, you know, the value planet, it's opposing a shadow of illusions and fantasy and stuff that's not quite solid. Does that mean it can't happen? No. You know, you can still make your dreams and your hopes a reality, but you just have to keep things in perspective. You have to make sure that you're being realistic. Keep expectations in check with any kind of desires or something that's happened that's given you news of some kind, maybe, or what you're thinking about for the future. Just make sure you're being grounded and practical, because that's going to be a little bit of an issue in general for people as you get to Friday, building up all week, but peaking on Friday here. You know, it can also play out through relationship stuff. Venus opposite Neptune. Are you being realistic in love? Are you being honest in love? You know, worst case scenario, I would say like deceptiveness, you know, people wanting to cheat, something more secretive going on within a relationship, or, you know, but that's like total worst case scenario. And based on where the moon is not in Cancer, doesn't like to like be too brave in those kind of ways. Typically, it's more, you know, internal, home and family, playing it safe, more cautious. I feel like it's more about family stuff, property stuff, the future for home and family matters. And it's more like a wish and a dream for the future, perhaps. But still, be cautious in relationship. Don't do anything dishonest. Don't do anything secretive behind the scenes, you know, or anything like that. Be careful of spending money this week, especially the second half of the week, you know, with the sun being amplified to Jupiter in the Taurus side of life and Neptune involved, like you could want something big, something, spend a lot, indulge in something. But again, those are worst case scenarios. And I feel like it's more about hopes and dreams and fantasies about something for the future that you really want in regards to home and family stuff. But relationships and the feminine could be very sensitive this week, very dreamy. You know, creative is another part of this. A lot of creativity being stirred up. And it could stir up some romance. Now, Venus is in Virgo. It's debilitated. It's practical. It's limited. But it's connecting to this bigger Pisces vibe of dreams and, you know, seeing the best side of something, seeing the good side of people, overlooking the flaws, ignoring the red flags, you know, stuff like that. So just be aware of that and indulge and, you know, enjoy the magic side of it, the dreamy side of it. You know, music, I think, is going to be a stronger desire for people in general this week. Music and creativity and retreat type of vibes, and trying to escape some of this intensity and this heaviness on some level, whether that's just in your mind or you literally go do something, or, again, dreams and hopes for the future for something you want. But at the same time, the moon is opposite Pluto, and that's always a little bit of a threat of some kind. I don't think the threat is as big as it was in the last cycle, like I said, when Mars was in Libra, square Pluto, square the moon, you know, so it's not going to be that intense, but there's still a bit of a creeper vibe out in the world, out in the about, you know, a little bit still of a threat to homes. You know, sometimes this could be, you know, an Earth event threatens homes. It's a little bit of an intense mood that has a little bit of fear. I just think that the Venus Neptune might override this particular phase with moon opposite Pluto. I don't think it's going to be as in the same way, or maybe it's water events or just something with a more earthly side to it that's still intense or something transformative to the mood and the circumstances. But I still like to call this a threat of some kind, you know, to home, family stuff, mood, circumstances, the power, the control, the intensity of what's going on in the world, government, you know, rules and laws and structures versus the mood, you know, that's more internal and sensitive. So there is some sort of a powerful situation most likely on Friday night, but I still feel like the Venus Neptune goes a long way in kind of escapism or avoidance or looking at the best of something. And I don't see that Mars is necessarily active in this as much. So there's always a possibility of violence, you know, that we're going to have to deal with continuously in this phase with Mars in this position, you know, but, and maybe something's coming up on Friday, but I can't guarantee it as much in this situation. But it does start to transform the mood, you know, when the moon is opposite Pluto, and there are some intense emotions and feelings and circumstances regardless. And then the moon will leave that as we get to Saturday, November 4. This is the beginning of when things start to get, you know, more intense and a change to the vibes, and Venus starts to separate from Neptune, you know, the fantasy and the dreams. It's still active, but things are going to get a lot more dramatic here when the moon is moving through Leo. And I think it starts on Friday night, but it really starts to show on Saturday as the moon ingresses Leo. It's more outward, dramatic, passionate. It still has a lot of creativity, the need for fun, but Saturn is stationing that day. It's more serious, and the moon is in conjunct to Saturn. It's like this mood in Leo that's more outward, playful, big-hearted, prideful, wanting to have fun and creative and express oneself, recreation. It's kind of at odds with this vibe of heaviness and seriousness and intensity that's going on at the same time. And that is the first aspect of the day on November 4th, Saturday, is Saturn stationing. So everything like I talked about in the beginning with Saturn, responsibilities, commitments, duties, obligations, we're picking up on that emotionally, and we have to start applying that in the outside world, you know, better boundaries, willing to commit to something, willing to deal with something that's a little more restrictive, limiting, hard work, you know, that we've had a little bit of a break on, internalizing it, working on it more privately, internally. Now we have to like apply it in an outward way. And this isn't just instantly on Saturday morning necessarily. This is for the next several months. We slowly start pushing things forward, you know, but also if you're under a Saturn transit in one of the mutable signs of Pisces, Gemini, Virgo, or Sagittarius, you start to feel the pressure a little more, most likely. The weight, the burden, the limitations, the things that you have to deal with, the karma that you've created that you're dealing with, you know, this year that's been in the making for years. You know, you didn't get to this point just out of the blue this year. A lot of this pressure, the Saturn stuff that you're dealing with, it's based on things of the past that you created, you know, whether it was in your control or not. It's about the past. And you have to deal with those realities now and look at the future and what you're going to build and commit to in this new way. But it's still going to kind of bring a more heavier vibe in for Saturday and Sunday. And it makes the sun in charge now with the moon moving through Leo. It's not in its own home anymore. It's not in charge of what's going on. And it's more coming back to this Scorpio vibe again. Of intensity, power, control, death and rebirth situations, financial situations, other people's money, other people's resources, and some tension that starts to build up from this point on. And then that's when Mercury is opposing Uranus. So there could be surprising news, something coming out that's a lot different, you know, that changes the mood, makes things more dramatic, makes things more intense again. And this overall financial opposition, and this opposition again that's being highlighted between the light and the dark, the good physical things of life of Taurus, the beautiful things, stable things versus Scorpio things that are deeper. And, you know, it's also about the mind going through changes and this revolutionary mindset of something different rather than attachment. You know, because all this Scorpio has a lot of deep attachment to things of the past that they don't want to let go of. They don't want to forget. And there's a need for change, you know, with Uranus involved, breaking free, liberation of the mind, liberation of attachments, looking at new possibilities, new options, or again, surprising news and information. Traveling concerns could play out, some dramatic transportation, traveling events. This gets a lot more dramatic in all these different ways, perhaps. Self-expression becomes more dramatic, more intense. And then the moon is square Jupiter. That just adds to this sense of everything overly amplified, overly intense. The moon is about to form the last quarter moon phase, you know, late on Saturday into Sunday. The last quarter moon, the crisis in consciousness about this whole cycle of eclipses and changes and intensity and everything that's already happened, we have to accept, we have to integrate, we have to become more whole, more balanced with all these new developments, you know, that have been happening. But with Jupiter being opposed and squared this week and weekend, everything is really big and amplified again, really intense and dramatic. Scorpio and Leo squares are the most dramatic. You know, it's like this fire and water, you know, it's like the lava flowing into the ocean. It's steaming, it's sizzling, it's just, it's kind of intense. And it leads back to Mars. Mars is in charge of it all, so everything about Mars is a part of this, if you think about it. And that leads us to the following day, on Sunday, November 5, the official last quarter moon phase. So the day starts off, it's basically Friday night all through Saturday. Saturday night into Sunday morning is some of the most intense things here of what's happening. But moon square sun, not as much cooperation. There's emotional challenges, blocks. There's things that we kind of have to accept. You know, it's not about just trying to control it, push through it, trying to find solutions. There's a part of this that says it's up in the mind. It's a consciousness issue that you have to emotionally accept things. You have to let go of things, you know, and try not to control. Try not to be too overly obsessive or attached to things that are outside of your control. But, you know, it could also bring up issues with children, could bring up issues of just something more expressive. It could also bring up like authorities and leaders, dramatic things on that level, but it is through the weekend. It could also bring up financial drama in some way as well, potentially. And then Mars is in conjunct to Chiron. That's not a good sign during this type of T-square going on. Mars, the ruler of all this, the violence, the aggressiveness, the intensity, causing more sensitivity, more wounds, you know. So there's likely some intense stuff, you know, going on in the world during this weekend. And then Moon is trine Chiron, so that's helpful. But then the Moon is square Mercury, Uranus, and Mars for Sunday, all day Sunday. So that trine to Chiron, why Mars is in conjunct to Chiron, you know, it's hard to say if that's something positive, because this is a lot of tension and drama. With Moon square Mars, the need for action, you know, this type of vibe forces people. Well, technically it doesn't force anything. It just shows that this is the dynamic in the air, that people are feeling this agitation, this aggressiveness, this need to do something, this need to fight for something, to take a stand, you know, that's prideful. A lot of pride is coming up with all this, with the T-square pointing towards Leo. Pride and it's a bit intense. There's no way around that. And then with the square to Uranus and Mercury, again, transportation or traveling issues are a little bit intense. Money and resources, news and information. The mind and the heart are on two different pages, and they're conflicting with change. You know, this battle against change and things that we'd rather keep the same and stable and secure from the past, we're forced to change here in some way, generally speaking, in a worldly context. All right, so that's Sunday. And then we get to Monday, November 6th. The moon is separating from all that, but still in conjunct to Pluto, and it's still a little bit edgy the first thing on Monday. The moon aligns with the nodes of fate, so All this is affecting the future, for the long-term future. Anything happening? Moon in conjunct to Neptune, having to make adjustments to things that are hard to understand or see or mysterious or the behind-the-scenes influences. Distractions on Monday. But then Venus does apply a trine to Pluto, and there begins to be this transformation for Venus from this point on. Venus, money and relationships begin to transform. So new financial developments could be moving forward by next week based on things that are happening this week. And, you know, that will lead to Venus ingressing Libra, her home sign, where Venus becomes much stronger. So all this leads to a stronger Venus. Venus is being empowered. Financial activities being empowered. Relationships begin to be empowered, especially in a work, service, money, financial aid context, government, you know, type of stuff, especially in that mundane context. And then Moon in conjunct to Pluto, like I said, and then the Moon changes signs, ingresses Virgo, and the mood becomes much more practical, much more grounded, less intense as we get deeper into Monday compared to the weekend. The weekend is chaotic and a bit crazy and you know, dramatic for good or bad. Well, Monday, we're much more grounded and practical, and work and service and health come up in more better ways. The moon does oppose Saturn first thing as it ingresses Virgo. So still that serious Saturn mood all week long and into next week. Responsibilities, commitments, boundaries, duties, obligations, all these things become a bigger feeling for people. Some restrictions, some limitations, you know, in the air, in the mood. But as the moon comes into Virgo, it's ruled by Mercury still, which is in conjunct to the north node of destiny, the future, making adjustments, and Mars still in charge of everything. So again, it's all about Mars and Scorpio kind of dictating the rules and the vibes, except when the moon is in Cancer. And then the Mercury is trine Neptune, so that adds this open outlet to mental retreat. The mind has already gone through a lot as well by the time we get to next week. So now we're thinking differently. It's aligned with the wishes, the hopes, the dreams, the fantasies, the imagination, very strong intuition going on here. It's more of the unspoken stuff, the connection to spirituality, divination, other realms, you know, is in alignment in that way by Monday night. And that's the last aspect of the week, folks. So I hope you got something out of that. Thanks for watching, and I wish you the very best. Take good care.